on. Welcome back to Heavy Metal Models. I'm even more excited than usual today. A car has come in that I've been seeing pictures of, as have you, over the past several months. This is CMC's Alfa Romeo 8C2900B, one of the cars that they built for Le Mans that year, and the only closed-bodied car. Truly a unique, one-of-a-kind automobile, and it makes for a great model. Check it out. Romeo. The name conjures up images of high-strung, spectacular-to-behold machines with stunning performance. That's especially true of the Alfas cobbled together in the 1930s, and doubly so when the result of that work was this amazing-looking 1938 8C2900B, hand-built by the factory's race team, Alfa Corse, to take on the world that year at Le Mans. Another remarkable effort, that of CMC in making this one-off car into such a charming sight and scale, has got to be applauded here. Straight out of its box, the model is a stunner, not only for its faithfulness to the Speciale's long, low shape, but for the myriad details that are seemingly everywhere on its die-cast and pressed metal shell. Louvers are punched through the car's sides, the shut lines on the doors, hood, and boot are very good, and the model rides on gorgeous spoked wheels, made all the more remarkable by a glistening coat of gloss black paint and skinny rubber tires. The oxblood red finish CMC's applied here is excellent, and after a light buffing, the paint came up with a believable sheen that rides the car's fenders and breadbox roofline evenly. All of the smaller detail pieces are incredible, and they're joined by watchmaker's screws, pin-sized rivets, tiny working hinges, leather straps, and latches that secure the secondary panels to the shell for an overall effect that's pure CMC. Front, a real metal mesh grille wears the classic Alfa Romeo script. Next to it, on either side, are deeply lensed headlamps and driving lights, followed at the rear by Superleggera scripts and touring badges. The Alfa Romeo at the top of the grille is a real cloisonné and looks great under magnification. While you have the loop out, check out the other badges and crests out back and the elaborate museum seal on the car's sides. Then have a peek at the interesting three-lamp taillight on the boot lid. The V'd windshield is framed with metal edges and it's been set into the casting precisely. On the glass sits a pair of neat photo-etched wiper assemblies. Below it is the leather-wrapped interior with a detailed multi-knob dash, glass-phased gauges, and realistic shifter and banjo-spoked steering wheel. The details in here are beautiful, but they're more about scale, fidelity, and display than any invitation to play. You can slide the front door glass back and forth, but the steering on this sample didn't seem to be connected to anything. Given the tightness of the carpeted, close-coupled cabin, that's probably a good thing, because getting my adult fingers in here was a risky business. After looking at the leather-lined doors and working the realistic hinges, I thought it better to step back and check out the neat little pedals, knobs, and underdash details from a safe distance. It's a beautiful sight that matches the real car perfectly. Equally delicate but easier to grasp are the little lock handles on the Alfa's trunk. Tweak these sideways and you can get into the car's boot for a look at the model's spare tire and a few elements of its tube frame. The finishes in here are realistic, and there's a wire run to the tail lamp as well as a clip-in prop rod and a socket to put it in. The car has a couple of other tricks up its sleeve for the more adventurous collector who's unafraid to dabble in small stuff, starting with a fuel filler that opens on an amazing little hinge. Use the included screwdriver to pull the four screws on each fender access panel, and they come off too, as do the spats over the rear wheels. Alfa's engines were state-of-the-art in their day, and CMC makes you work for the chance to see theirs in scale. But once the real leather straps and buckles are open, the 220-horse straight-8 DOHC motor is a piece that makes all that scary stuff worth the effort. The castings are flawless, and so are the finishes to replicate the 2.9-liter twin supercharged engine's underhood palette of silvers, metallics, and polished pieces. Around all of that, the fabric-wrapped ignition leads, real rubber hoses, metal clamps, and all of that bent copper and steel wire add dimension and realism that starts with the spark plugs and coiled cables up top and ends at the deeply detailed, legibly labeled firewall. There's even a speed rack for the lube and vital fluids the car might carry for a road trip or on race day. All four rims are removable. Up front, the spoked units are mounted to mildly posable steering and working suspension. Out back, the axle is locked down, but the detail under the model is startling, with a real metal frame hosting dozens of added-on assemblies for the front and rear suspension, the fully realized steering linkage, full wiring and cabling for the brakes, fuel, and oil lines, a comprehensively detailed transaxle replete with rubber joint boots and metal clamps, a steel transverse leaf spring, and a stainless steel fuel tank. Alongside it all, the Alfa's hammer-finished exhaust ends in a hollow salami tip. A second look revealed wiring run to the horns up front and more electrical detailing run to the headlamps and driving lights. Yet another look a few minutes later revealed an almost impossible-to-believe detail, screening in the rear brake cooling horns mounted on either side. Anywhere I looked, there were dozens, if not hundreds, of pieces on display. Leather, stainless, copper, and steel. Pieces were bent, hammered, soldered, upholstered, polished, or painted, and each was placed exactly where it belonged, more often than not with screws and rivets. Very few model makers can aspire to this kind of detail, and only one manages to do so while leaving the most important part, the obvious touch of the human hand, so proudly on display. Like the Alfa name, another brand name, CMC, is becoming synonymous with spectacular products, and this latest release falls in line as a masterpiece of automotive art that will entertain a few lucky collectors for many, many years.
Years, I've used the phrase museum quality to talk about a model that was so good that it would be at home in a museum display. And you know, I was almost tempted to use that phrase again, but here's the deal about a museum model. You're never going to walk into a museum and have the curator say, "Here, check this out. CMC gives you a screwdriver and a pair of tweezers and dares you to take the thing apart." It's that cool. Behind every piece is another piece. Behind every panel was something else to see and something else to do. And what's really great about that is that it's not something that this company really publicizes or makes a big deal about. It's just kind of an is with these guys. It's a really remarkable car, even a cut above their usual remarkable model cars. Very highly recommended. Hey, if there's a model you want to see on Heavy Metal Models, let me know. Joe at HeavyMetalModels.com. Please join us on the Facebook page. It's a great community, you guys. You can post pictures of your collection, check out their collection, and just interact with some really cool people. And please subscribe to us right here on the YouTube channel. This way you'll get to see these videos before anybody else. I appreciate you coming down here. You're the reason we do the show. Thanks a lot. We'll see you later. Bye.